Hey, and welcome to another video. So today we're gonna be running through the wizard and doing some basic settings on a Hikvision DVR. So this is using the latest GUI 5.0, which is the latest firmware and software from Hikvision, and all the new DVRs are gonna be coming with this. So you might have seen our previous wizard videos for the older version. So it's basically the same thing, but just with the latest menu. Okay, so we're gonna run through the automatic wizard. Then after that, we're just gonna go through some more basic settings you might wanna change on the menu. And then we're gonna do a simple camera setup. We just plug in the camera, make sure it's all okay, change the name, those type of things. Okay, so a very basic video, but with the new menu. So I hope you guys like it, and we'll catch you on the beginning of the wizard in a second. Cheers, thanks. Okay, so we're on the DVR wizard now, and we're just gonna quickly run through this, then we're gonna go ahead and plug in the camera and do some basic settings, okay? All using the new 5.0 GUI, the latest interface from Hikvision, okay? So first of all, we have to add a password, pretty simple. So we're just gonna do CCTV, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I obviously recommend you choose something else. And really don't forget it, because it can be a pain to get the passwords back and get access to your system. Okay, so I made a mismatch here, so I just put a 4 up here. And now they match, okay. And now camera activation password. Okay, if you want to add IP cameras, then put in your IP password camera here. But I'm just going to use the device password, which is CCTV 12345. Okay, then so let's activate it. Okay, so we're activated now, and if you do want to pop in an email address here, go ahead and do that, just in case you do forget your password. And we can go ahead here and go enable Hik Connect. So we're gonna go okay here, and connection currently offline, so make sure your DVR is connected to the router, which ours is. So it should say in a second online, so let's quickly click back and come back again. Okay, online. Okay, apply that, and then we're going to come back. Okay, still offline, just give it a second, it usually comes on. Okay, online now. Okay, so the verification code, I recommend also for this, you change it. So just stick with CCTV or whatever your password is. Okay, so when you download the app, and it's going to ask you for the verification code, okay? So I'm not going to talk about much in the app on this video, because I've got a whole video dedicated to it. But what you have to do is go ahead and download Hik Connect app or Hiluk Vision. I'll leave a link below. And then what you have to do is scan the QR code with your Wi-Fi off. But I recommend, if you're having problems with the app, then check out my video link below. Okay, so this is what it means now. It's online. It's ready to go for the app to be added. Okay, and security questions, you can do this as well. But I never do. If you've got your email address in here, that's good enough. Okay, so we've set the password reset up. Okay, just in case we're gonna have problems in the future. Now we go to manual config. Okay, so I don't want an unlock pattern, so I'm just gonna go disable unlock pattern. Okay, so first things first, choose the time zone. It's already set to London time, day, month, year. Okay, and you can sync it to the internet. So if you do NTP time sync, it's going to take the time from Google. Oh, I like that, so I'm just going to go next. Okay, so you want this on. DHCP you want on if you're going to go online. Okay, so just leave that as it is. All right then, so this is the hard drive. So I assume you've put in a brand new hard drive and you want to go ahead and format it. So it's simple. So click on here, click on initialize, and then go ahead and click on OK. All right, so let's quickly do that now. As you see here, initializing is basically the same as formatting. Okay, you might be familiar with that term. So we're just quickly formatting the hard drive, and status RW, that's perfect. It might say normal or RW, that's what you want. If it says abnormal, or you hear some beeping now or some problems, you might have a faulty hard drive. So I'll check out our videos on how to fix that issue. Okay, so we go next. All right, so these are IP cameras. All right, I'm not going to go into adding IP cameras to a DVR, but if you do want to add an IP camera, you'll see that they all come up in the list below here. Okay, but we're just going to skip that section for now. We'll go next, and we're back to the HitConnect thing again, which we've already set up. So online, ready to go. Just download the app, scan the code, and we'll be able to go ahead and get online. All right, let's just finish that. Okay, so that's the wizard run through. Okay, so now we have this new interface, and we're gonna go ahead and plug in the camera now, and I'll show you a few more settings. All right, hold on. All right, so I plugged in the camera, the picture came straight up. It's a 5 megapixel audio camera, but we're gonna go ahead and look at that in more detail in a second. First of all, we're just gonna quickly make sure all the settings are okay, and make sure you are in expert mode. Okay, so at bottom left-hand corner, we've got easy and expert mode. This is expert mode where you see there's more menus, all right? So we're in the general menu now. Make sure everything looks good, the time is all set, and make sure the wizard now is grayed out, because we ran through the wizard, we don't want that coming up and up again when we restart the DVR. And I like to disable the password, because it just keeps popping up every now and then when you want to do something. But obviously, if you want, you know, people not to go on your CCTV, then leave the password on. All right, so make sure daylight savings is set correctly. I set it to the last Sunday in March and the last Sunday in October. That's perfect, done already. And we can change the name here, so I'm just going to call this Office DVR. Okay, apply that. And then the live view. Okay, so as you see here, window division 1+7, which means you get one big window and then seven small ones. Okay, so if you want to change that, you could change it to say 4x4. Let's apply that, and then you get more up here. Okay, so it's really depending on what you like. All right, I like my 1+7, so I'll apply that. And if you want audio on the live view, you can switch it on and off from here, but you've got easy tabs on the menu. Let me show you. So on here, you've got audio on and off here anyway, so it's up to you if you want to use that feature. That's pretty much it. Okay, so if you do want to mix some cameras up, you want the, say, A2 to be on the main one, you can do that. So we grab A2 here. Oh. Okay, get rid of A2 here, and then you can select AT for this one. Okay, so you click on the one you want and then make here A1. I want the main one to be A1, just leave it like normal, and make this one A2. So you can get it how you like, really. You got all these different things down here as well. You can play around with it to get it just how you like the live view. Okay, channel 0 will be for if you have a BNC output, which most people really don't use nowadays. Okay, you want to change your password, you can go to the user here, change it, put in the admin password, and just follow that through for changing the password. Okay, so network settings, we don't really want to touch anything here, but if you do get stuck on the app, go to platform access and all your app information is all on here. Okay, and then we've got the camera. Okay, so these are analog cameras. It means we've got 8 assigned, which is what we want, and we have IP cameras here which we can add. We're not going to do that. Okay, so we'll come back to this menu later. This is setting up the camera, but right now we're just going to finish setting up the DVR. So we go to event. So events also to do with setting up the camera. So if you want to set up motion detection or smart features, we can do that. Okay, so what we're going to do for now is just go to record. And as you see here, if it says enable under schedule, that means your camera will be recording. All right. So it's set for 24/7 recording. You can change that. You know, if you want just Monday, you don't want it to record certain times of the day, you can change the schedule. We go to advanced here, make sure record audio is selected. Okay, that means you'll get the audio recorded with the video. Okay, parameter, this is also to do with setting up the camera, so I'll come back to this in a minute. We have storage. All right, this is your hard drive. If you want to format your hard drive again or check to make sure it's all working, you can go here. And there's not really much here. This is a much more useful. So the other menus we have is playback. So if you want to playback any footage, You can select the camera and then select the time down here. And we have smart search as well. So if you're not too familiar with smart search, I'd check out the link below and learn how to use that. I've just done a video on that. It's really good with the latest DVRs. So that's pretty much our DVR setup. As you see, there's not really many settings you have to do nowadays. Okay, it's all pretty much set for plug and play. And now we'll go ahead and look at the camera we're plugged in and make sure everything is good with that. All right, catch you there. Okay, our camera's plugged in, and as you see, we've got a nice live view. We haven't had to do anything. They've made analog systems really easy now to use. So we're going ahead and go to the camera features on the menu and set it up from here. Okay, actually we want to go to the record features. Okay, so our camera one is the one we're using, and it's enabled, the schedule perfect, the recording, the audio perfect. So we go to parameters. Okay, so stream type video and audio. If you want to turn the audio off, this is where you do it from. But now it comes preset for audio. Audio source, you want to use camera audio. Okay, so if you do auto, it should be fine. And here, you make sure the maximum resolution is selected, 5 megapixel. That's what we want. Variable bitrate is recommended. And you can go to the highest here if you want. Doesn't make a whole load of difference. And we click on apply. Okay, so the one setting I have changed is because the recording software is doesn't like it too much. It's 8265. So if recording time is something you're worried about, if you enable H265 here, you're going to get more recording. Okay, but do not enable H265 plus unless you know what you're doing. Okay, because it will turn off a lot of features, and just so it concentrates on recording. But H265 is usually more than enough and will give you plenty of recording time. Okay. So that's your basic setup for the camera. And now we've got the substream as well. Okay, so that's the main stream for the main recording. Now, if for the app, for example, if you want to get like they send you a lower quality stream, what you want to make sure is audio is enabled or not enabled if you want that. And you'll see that the settings here are pretty low, but that's good enough for the substream, all right? So we go back to the left here, that's our hard drive. Okay, so we go back to the camera options. We have camera here on the left, camera display here on the left. Okay, so this is where we change the name of the camera. So we just call this office camera. Let's call it office camera one. Okay, so we apply that. So let's change the name now on the camera, and we can change the date. We want day, month, year, in good old English style. And if you don't want the time, you don't want the camera name here, you can remove it all. You've got a few settings here you could change. For example, indoor mode, let's change it to indoor mode. See what happens. Not a lot happens here. But you see that you've got dim light is a good one. If you're in a low light area, I recommend checking that out. And then camera parameter settings. Just make sure everything here is set to the highest when it comes to megapixel. And that's pretty much it. So the camera's pretty much come preset now, so not loads to change. We've got privacy masking over here if you want to draw an mark out an area. So here we can apply that, and it's going to leave a black box on the live view, as you can see here. Okay, so that's privacy masking. All right. Okay. So not a hell of a lot to set up, really. Pretty straightforward nowadays. That is your basic stuff. And now once the camera has started recording, you will see this red icon up here. So you see this red, that means something is recording. So we can go back to the playback. And you'll see here now, we have a little bit of playback. Yep, there we go. So everything's working good. Okay, so that's your basic setup for Hikvision DVR with a camera using the latest GUI 5 interface. Okay, so I'll leave a whole bunch of links below, and thank you guys for watching. If you've got any questions, feel free to ask, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thanks guys, bye.